You know, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life.
Today is Friday, March 24th, 2023. My name is Delaney. Happy birthday to Emery in Miss Sims' classroom and Jameson in Miss Cook's classroom. On Sunday, happy birthday to Carly, Raina, and Evie. Stay tuned for the core value announcements about forgiveness.
Our core value is forgiveness, and our color is mint. The color mint is one of refreshment. It gives off the same sentiment when we forgive someone. Forgiving is good for you. Forgiveness is a voluntary, deliberate change in feeling towards someone who has caused you hurt or harm. It involves letting go of negative emotions towards the offender and results in a decreased desire for retaliation or revenge. Forgiveness is refreshing.
Today in history, March 24th, 1989, Exxon Valdez oil spill. The Exxon Valdez oil spill was a man-made disaster that occurred when Exxon Valdez, an oil tanker owned by the Exxon Shipping Company, spilled 11 million gallons of crude oil into Alaska's Prince William Sound on March 24, 1989. It was the worst oil spill in U.S. history until 2010. The Exxon Valdez oil slick covered 1,300 miles of coastline and killed hundreds of thousands of seabirds, otters, seals, and whales. Nearly 30 years later, pockets of crude oil remain in some locations. After this spill, Exxon Valdez returned to service under a different name. On the evening of March 23rd, Exxon Valdez left the port of Alaska, bound for Long Beach, California, with 53 million gallons of crude oil on board. Approximately 4 minutes after midnight on March 24th, the ship struck a reef, which is a well-known navigation hazard. The impact of the collision tore open the ship's hull, causing some 11 million gallons of crude oil to spill into the water. At the time, it was the largest single oil spill in U.S. waters. Initial attempts to contain the oil failed, and in the months that followed, the oil slick spread, eventually covering 1,300 miles of coastline. Investigators later learned that Joseph Hazelwood, the captain of the Exxon Valdez ship, had allowed an unlicensed third mate to steer the massive ship. Exxon paid about $2 billion in cleanup costs and $1.8 billion for a habitat restoration and personal damages related to the spill. Cleanup workers skimmed oil from the water's surface, sprayed oil dispersing chemicals in the water and on shore, washed oiled beaches with hot water, and rescued and cleaned animals trapped in oil. As a result, the Oil Pollution Act of 1990 was passed by President George H.W. Bush. It was signed into law later that year. The Oil Pollution Act of 1990 increased penalties for companies responsible for oil spills and required that all oil tankers in the United States waters have a double hull.
Let's end today's announcements by remembering the STAR expectations. Today and every day, strive to do your best.
Take responsibility for your actions.
Always be safe.
Respect people and property. Have a great day, Bearsville.
Now please stand for the playing of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.